Hey everybody, welcome to week one of Advent. We're sort of entering into this beautiful season, heading up to Christmas. And I think all of us have those different questions on our heart of like, how can I enter into Advent well? How can I prepare for Christmas well? And I wanted to spend a little bit of time with you each of these weeks to engage those questions and dig into how it was that the characters we see in the gospel stories approaching Christmas, how do they do it? And this week, I want to start you off with a surprising character. The Archangel Gabriel. Here's the question I want to put in your mind. Remember or recall a time when somebody told you, hey, I've just gotten engaged, I'm going to get married to this person, you know, in 6 months or whatever. Or somebody sends you a message and is like, we're expecting a child, right? And this is the due date. They just told you the news. I want you to feel in your heart, to like kind of imagine for yourself what that excitement was like, what that joy was like, what that thrill, what went through your mind when you first got a piece of news along those lines. Now, imagine that magnified to the extreme, because that's the kind of message that Gabriel was given, right, to carry to Mary. And we just get that beautiful line from St. Luke's Gospel where it says, the Archangel Gabriel was sent by God to the town of Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to Joseph, and the virgin's name was Mary, right? But what was it like for him to make that trip from heaven down to Nazareth to carry that message? And here's where this all fits together. Where did he get that message from? He got that message. He got that good news. He got that truth that changes everything and fills him with joy by standing by being in front of God, right? Being in the presence of the Lord. That's where the angels are, right? They stay there in front of the Lord. They just adore him. They wonder at him. They glorify him. But now that prayer that he's making gets turned into this joyful message, right, that he's bringing to Our Lady. And this is where we can kind of copy him, or we can kind of enter into that same mentality, right? What can we do during the season of Advent to give just a little bit of time in the presence of God? And can we trust that he's going to use that time to kindle in our hearts that same kind of joy? I think we all want that kind of joy. We want to be bearers of that same kind of truth, that same message, right? It's just as true for us as it was for Gabriel. But the thing that allowed him to go into that, to receive that, was simply that time spent with the Lord. So concretely, this week, try to carve out consistently, every single day. Pick some time that's going to work for you all the way through Advent where you can carve out 5 minutes or 10 minutes just to spend with God every day and let him do the rest. Sounds good? God bless.